Camos in Call of Duty have become a staple of the Call of Duty franchise. We expect lots of camos, lots of challenges, and tons of ways to personalize our weapons. And we all strive to get the ultimate camo, whether it be gold, diamond, dark matter, or whatever it may be in the COD of your choice. But camos have come a very long way, and we didn't always have so many choices. What's up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos, and today we're going to go over the history of gun camos in the Call of Duty franchise. So drop a like on the video, sit back for a few minutes, and let's take a journey down the path, the history of camos. Camos made their first appearance in Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare and were initially a display of skill with the weapon, as each camo was unlockable through getting a certain amount of headshots. But as this was all very new to the COD series at the time, there were only a handful of camos available for each weapon, and the ultimate achievement, the creme de la creme, was gold, and it was only available for one weapon per class: the AK-47, the Desert Eagle, the Mini Uzi, the M10-14, the M60E4, and the Dragunov. This practice carried over into Modern Warfare 2, as every weapon had a variety of camos to unlock through completing headshot challenges, again showing off a player's skill with each individual weapon. However, in Modern Warfare 2, the ultimate camo achievement was the Fall camo, which was unlocked after getting 250 headshots with that certain gun. Camos were originally supposed to be in World at War, but were cut last minute in an effort to save game space, and because Treyarch reportedly didn't like how they ended up looking. After Modern Warfare 2 came Call of Duty Black Ops, and then the camos took a very different path in this title. You see the evolution of the camo as we go through this. New camos were no longer unlocked through challenges, but were rather bought using COD points, which were very different from the COD points that you and me know today, as these were earned through multiplayer and had nothing to do with DLC or supply drops or actually spending real money. Each camo was 250 points, and the gold camo returned as the ultimate camo achievement once again, but was only available after reaching 14th prestige, and it cost 50,000 COD points, which, if you've played Black Ops 1 multiplayer, you know how insanely expensive that could be at that time. Then we moved on to Modern Warfare 3, where the weapon system changed a little bit from the previous titles. Modern Warfare 3 was the first Call of Duty to have weapon levels, and the camos were unlocked by ranking up your weapon. This was the first time we've ever seen a rank up system that was specifically attached to your weapon, which a lot of people enjoyed. Each weapon had 31 levels, and the gold camo was unlocked at level 31, which took a lot of time and a lot of skill to actually get to. Modern Warfare 3 was really the game where gold camo became a showing of skill when you saw someone using it online. And can you guys remember back far enough to when somebody had gold camo on their gun, it was an achievement. It was a sense of pride, and they carried it, and people looked at them and said, you know what? This person knows what they're doing, or this person has at least put in a ton of time into this game. After Modern Warfare 2, we got Black Ops 2, which went back to the headshot system for camos, but was also the first time the game introduced attachment challenges after the headshot challenges, and was also the first COD to feature DLC camos. That's right, this was game-changing. Black Ops 2 is where camos took a completely different path, if you will, and there were a ton of DLC camos. Some people would say to this day that Treyarch and Black Ops 2 put out the coolest camos, even to this day with the current Call of Duties. Man, those were the days when you just threw down a couple bucks for a bunch of cool camos. No supply drops. Black Ops 2 was also the first game where you could go into battle with just your knife and actually allowed the player to add customization to their knife. And it also introduced the highly sought after diamond camo, which started out as a secret camo, but once everybody knew about it, the grind was on. This was one of the true grind tests for a Call of Duty player when it came to getting an upper echelon camo, and people to this day say that the diamond camo grind is still by far the best one yet. So it's safe to say that Black Ops 2 established the camo system we are familiar with today, where camos are unlocked through different challenges, with gold being the highest for each individual weapon, and then getting gold on every weapon would result in unlocking an extra camo, whether that be diamond, or whether that be another step up and be dark matter. But we didn't stop there. Then we got into Call of Duty Ghost, and they tried to build off of the crazy camos from Black Ops 2. And then we saw camos get a little bit ridiculous. You could have space kittens, you could have rubber duckies, all types of different camos. Now, don't get me wrong, there were some really cool looking camos in Call of Duty Ghosts, but once again, the lid was taken off and we started to see Call of Duty explore more, extreme camo types. And then we move forward to Advanced Warfare. And this is where things get pretty crazy in the form of not only camos, the challenges pretty much stayed the same to a degree. That Black Ops 2 kind of set the precedent for how the challenges worked. But then we had supply drops introduced and you could acquire things from the supply drop. But it's also safe to say that Advanced Warfare took a step back in my opinion when it comes to the extremism of camos. Now, when it comes to exosuits, that's a different story. But you had camos like multicam, urban, digital urban, concrete. It was almost more of a bland selection of camos. And there were DLC camos like creature and magma, nanotech, things like that. But for the most part, at the launch of the game, it was a very, very subtle camo repertoire, if you will, as opposed to their predecessors in Call of Duty Ghost and Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Then we move forward to Black Ops 3. And not only did we go right back and ramp them up and get all kinds of crazy camos in Black Ops 3, but they also instituted a system where you could actually create camos, or they were known as paint jobs. And this was the first time that we had ever actually seen this in a game. And once again, a lot of people love this. It created a new community, not just for emblems anymore, but you could actually create very, very cool paint job / camos on your favorite weapon of choice. And there is no shortage of camos in Black Ops 3. And then we come to present day. Infinite Warfare has probably the craziest, biggest arsenal of camos already, and the game is not halfway through its cycle yet. We got the infamous DLC drop, or whatever you want to call it, with over 100 or 200 camos at one time. It's safe to say that the days of the gold camo, or the diamond camo, or the fall camo being the sought-after camos that people would appreciate you when you were on the field are gone. Now you will see a camo that you may never see again in the form of Infinite Warfare, and it could have came in a supply drop, or it could have been earned through achievements. But there's so many out there that they just don't have that shine and luster that they used to. So there you go, guys. That is a look at the history, or evolution, if you will, of camos in Call of Duty. They are a staple. They are a mainstay. They are a very important part of the game for a lot of people in this community. And all I can say, my personal opinion, is that I wish it would go back. I wish it would go back to where you had a certain standard, and if you had a certain camo, it wasn't because you got lucky and got it out of a supply drop. It was because you earned it, and when people saw it, that there was a sense of respect that you earned that camo. Will we ever go back to that? I highly doubt it. I wish we would, but forward thinking says that's probably not going to happen, because we live in a day and age where it's what can you give me now? 5 minutes ago doesn't matter. What have you done for me lately? And it seems like people's attention spans on a certain camo are gone within a day or so, and they want something new. Yet, a lot of people will argue the same point, that they wish it would go back to that classic style. So we'll have to wait and see. Maybe Call of Duty 2017 will surprise us in more ways than one. And you guys, let me know what you think in the comment section. What is your best camo story? Your best story of grinding and unlocking camo, and you were super proud of it, shared it with your friends, and people online. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And if you want to see any more history of video game type videos like this, definitely let me know on Twitter in the comment section, and I'll try to make it happen. I'll see you guys later.